Well, now it's on to our hot tips and country highlights segment broadcast. Since we're having a graduation theme today, we decided we'd focus on graduate degree grants.
Yeah, but the special ones.
Yes.
So let's talk about what makes the graduate degree programs special, as opposed to the grants where you would apply in the open category for just any study award. Mm-hmm. There are also then grants that are sometimes not in the open study category and not in the ETA category. And then at that point, what is it? What does it mean? Like, let's talk about it.
Yeah, let's
we
work
should
through
actually
that.
Do one as an example. Randomly pick one. This one.
Taiwan. You've actually been to Taiwan.
I have been to Taiwan. I've been to Taiwan and I've actually met the Fulbright Executive Director of the In-Country Commission there, William Boki.
Look at you name dropping. Mm-hmm. Just dropping all the names.
If you want to go to Taiwan, I've got some insider tips.
Insider scoops.
Yeah.
So tell us about Taiwan.
Okay, so essentially, if you navigate to the Taiwan country page, you're going to see there's quite a number of open study awards, 8. There are 90 English teaching awards. And then all those awards are going to be like the special graduate degree awards are sandwiched in between those two on the in-country page. For example, they have 3 doctoral degree programs at National Tsing Shan University. They have 1 master's degree program at National Taiwan Normal University. They have 2 masters in creative industries design. They have 3 masters in international studies Asia Pacific awards.
All you people listen to that one.
Yeah,
that one I think is
very popular.
Yes.
And why is it popular? Why are these programs? Does everybody speak Mandarin?
They're all taught in English.
Right, so this means you get a cultural immersion experience in Taiwan. You get a graduate degree program completely funded. There's a number of different types of specialties that are offered through the Taiwanese grant opportunities. And they're taught in English, so you don't need to have Mandarin. You will get to pick up some while you're there, but they're taught in English. So if you find one of those special awards that meets an academic goal or need, so say you are interested in international studies with a focus on East Asia Pacific, then maybe that award is one you should apply for. There's a couple of reasons why. Tell us one of the reasons why.
Because first of all, those grants are often under applied to.
Mm-hmm.
So whereas some of like the open study research awards, quite a few people are drawn to those because they can choose any, if they offer a graduate degree enrollment, they can choose any institution and country. The ones that are more specific at those partner institutions are often, I think, overlooked.
They're often been overlooked. So essentially, yeah. If you're interested in doing Fulbright and you want a master's degree, you should perhaps come talk to us if you haven't identified one, and we might have some suggestions for you of countries where you could get a master's degree in English in a foreign country.
Well, taught in English in a foreign country.
Taught in English in a foreign country.
Yes. Though keep in mind, this is not just like study abroad. I mean, though even study abroad, you should have a good reason for why you're doing the program you're doing. But there really does need to be an argument for fit with the program and how this is adding to your academic and professional development.
Yeah, so there's some nuance there.
Yes.
If you have questions,
let
you
want to
talk about it, what do they do?
What do? You sign up for an individual advising appointment.
With links. Either?
Well, either of us, yeah.
With either
LP.
Or LT.
It's down below us where you sign up. But wait until the end of this. Don't leave yet.
Okay. We've come to that time.
Now, I know this is the one that you all love because you get to learn more about us.
Mm-hmm.
This is time for the questions from our Fulbright fan club.
Before we get into the questions from our Fulbright fan club, there's something that you can do to win a Fulbright Fan Club prize. We're now giving away prizes to the first individual that will email fulbright@georgetown.edu with a question that, you know, any kind of question about something you want to know about your advisors. Appropriate questions because you are because you're our fans and you want to know more. Like, what do you like to eat for breakfast? Or you know, like, what kind of shampoo do you use? There's lots of things we could tell you.
Yeah, because as we become more famous, you can say, hey,
I asked them one of the first questions
yeah. when they just got started.
So fulbright@georgetown.edu, send us next week's question. If you're the first one, we will absolutely reply, request for your mail address, and send you one of our prizes.
Yep.
But, question.
We have a question.
We have only one question.
One question. But but it's an important question, I'm sure.
I'm sure. I'm sure it fits with the theme.
So this question comes from Bond. That's all it's written, just Bond.
From Vermont?
Bond.
Oh, yeah. Bond.
Bond.
I thought it was from Vermont. No, I'm like, what cheese Bond. Do you like? Yeah.
Munster.
I think it's cheddar in Vermont, but whatever.
Whatever. So Bond says
Bond.
That Bond.
Like bail bonds or James
like Bond?
Bond. Oh, 007.
It's kind of like the graduation theme song. Anyway, Bond.
Bond.
Bond says that his parents are going to allow him to go on any trip.
First of all, his
parents. First for graduation.
Wait, hold on. His parents are going to fund him on any trip for a graduation?
Yeah, that's just crazy.
Okay, so he should say thank you.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Hashtag gratitude.
Thank you. Yeah, hashtag gratitude. Thank your parents.
Yes. And he asks, where should I go for this graduate trip?
Burger King.
You know, there have been some people who've, like, done prom at Burger King, who've, like, taken the, you know, like, a tablecloth and done candles.
Yeah, I'm all about that. I don't think you need to, like, go all uppity with your trips.
Yeah.
Okay? So I'm going to say...
Or just local Water World.
Yeah. Good.
But Water Worlds are kind of gross because stuff gets in the
I don't
water.
Like water and people mixed. This is I don't like water theme parks. I also don't like doing the dishes because I don't like wet food. I just think there's something
it's
about
gross.
Like
or the
food,
sponge when the food is on sponge.
I don't like sponges. I don't
have
like,
I told you about my Water World story?
No, do you have a Water World story?
I do have a Water World story.
Okay, tell me.
One of my swimsuit got caught at the top of the ride.
does my fan club want to know about this?
Just
okay.
Be careful that when you are in a water park on a tube that you're not touching the slide because things can get caught.
Top will just...
Yeah, no, actually...
Sailing.
My I wouldn't say swim trunks. That's like what...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wear.
Yeah. I mean, but like swimsuits.
I don't want to be
ripped.
Gender conforming. Like if
ripped.
You want to wear trunks, you can wear trunks.
And I screamed, as you would. And the people behind us asked the like lifeguard at the top, like, oh, is this really that scary? And they said, like, I don't think so. I don't know what's happening. But as I was going down the ride, I was trying to keep my swimsuit together.
Oh my gosh. So it, definitely no.
Yeah.
Is that another irrational fear, water slides that you have?
I mean, I don't think I've been to a water park since, so that could have been led to irrational fear.
Okay. Anyway, so where should this Bond go on his graduation trip? You can go anywhere. Do you have anything? I mean, I guess maybe I wouldn't go to Burger King.
So I would say go to a national park.
Nice.
Take in like nature, be one with nature.
Yeah.
Come like come and reflect on your achievement.
Yeah. Do you know single tasking is the new multitasking?
Really?
That's what it is now.
It's the trendy
it's
thing.
No longer cool if you multitask. You single task.
So
if you
can
unplug.
Yeah, unplug.
Go
sit on your phone. Go sit on a mountain.
On top or just near?
You know, maybe like, 8,000 feet. You know, somewhere in there. Medium.
Do you need to train like altitude training for 8,000 or
probably
is that like
if you go above 8,000
it's like that's
icy.
The line
so maybe not some of the mountains in Colorado but like you know general hills
like
around
hills.
Here
hills like capital
but
hills?
I still want you to have like a nice view landscape
okay
because
so
it's
the view
it's important to
one with nature
have a perspective
reflect
upon your
yeah I just say go for the Whopper